Lamia Robinson goes to a skating rink to have fun. She's a young African-American girl in Michigan, but it doesn't wind up that way. So let's tell you the story. We're gonna go to Newsweek here through Daily Poster. Lamia Robinson had her face scanned at Riverside Arena in Livonia, Michigan, and was mistaken for someone who was involved in an altercation there earlier this year. She took a photo of the scan, which her mother, Julia Robinson, later posted to Facebook. And guess what happened? They said, nope, you're a criminal. You started a fight here earlier and we're gonna throw you out. She's like, no, I'm not. That's not me. They're like, no, we did facial recognition software and it says it is you. It says it has a 97% match, so off you go. And they throw her out. And it turns out, of course she's not lying. It's not her. And they threw out the wrong person. So let's show you here the picture. So there's a lot more I want to talk about in the story, including how racial profiling is disastrous no matter what. But as people look at that picture, I'm gonna do a divergence here and I'm gonna ask Bridget and Jackson something, okay? I gotta be honest, guys. When I first looked at that picture, I thought they do look similar, right? And but I'm not black, so I, you know, I hope I'm not doing, hey, doesn't Charles Barkley look like Barack Obama? Right? So now, by the way, they admit they did not have a human look at both of those pictures. They only did facial recognition. And facial recognition is a disaster for other reasons, which I'll explain in a second. But Bridget, just out of curiosity, did you think they look similar or no?
I mean, they're both black girls with braids and glasses.
Yeah.
Like I could sort of see it at first glance, but that's exactly why these kinds of technologies should not be used in the first place, because it's so faulty and so easy to make these kinds of mistakes.
Jackson?
Yeah, and I think that, you know, there's several takeaways from this. One, this technology clearly is not ready to be used in any type of industrial or mass scale. Therefore, the results can't be trusted. However, it's still being used and will continue to be used. And this poses a huge problem really for anybody who isn't rich, because these types of cases can be arbitrarily thrown against people. And even if they're not, even if it's a genuine mistake, these types of things, when they go to court, cost money. And most people don't have the money to fight these cases. I've had personal experience with this. Several years ago, I got pulled over by New Jersey state troopers, and they gave me two breathalyzer tests, both of which I blew a 0.0 in, and yet they still tried to give me a DUI case. And if I didn't have a lawyer, I would have gotten charged for drunk driving, even though I blew a 0.02 times. Just as an example of how these types of things screw people in the court system. And so we got a faulty technology being used that of course will disproportionately affect minority communities specifically.
Well, that's actually a statistical fact. So I wanna get to that in a second. But before I do, one last thing about the picture. If you didn't just use software and you used human judgment, put up the picture for one more time, guys. And I wanna show you something. Even if you're like me and you thought like, man, I do look kind of similar to be honest, right? Look, they have different glasses on. Right? So a human could tell that, and Lamia could tell you that, but they didn't have a human use judgment. They just said the software says you're a criminal, so you're a criminal and you have to leave. It's crazy, right? So all right, now let me give you the rest of the story. Julia Robinson says, to me, it's basically racial profiling. You're just saying every young black brown girl with glasses fits the profile, and that's not right. And well, it's hard to argue with that, because again, they have different glasses on, so any person could have looked at it and when you point that out, go, oh right, no, you're right, my bad, right? Or hey, you know, the ask questions, have a conversation. We can't just rely on computers to tell us who's criminal and who's not, especially when they misidentify African Americans more regularly. So which brings me to this point. Tawana Petty of Data for Black Lives pointed out that research has shown such software disproportionately misidentifies people of color. Facial recognition does not accurately recognize darker skin tones, Petty said. But I know from covering this story before, it also has great difficulty identifying Asians more correctly, right? It does a pretty good job with whites. And by the way, in this, we talk about this in the case of the algorithms too. Well, what biases are built into the algorithms? Well, who wrote the algorithms? oftentimes it's white males, and those biases are put in. And in this case, I don't know who wrote the software for all this facial recognition software, but you know, likely it was again the same group of folks. And look at that, it can't tell black people apart, it can't tell Asians apart. So now I'm gonna go to one other thing here that's such a good point. So this is a tweet. We, including children, are subjected to facial recognition, Tawana Petty says, again, same person I quoted earlier. Are subjected to facial recognition everywhere we go. This conflation between surveillance and safety only serves to further commodify human beings. True safety will never be delivered by an algorithm. It will be nurtured by a village that sees each other. Bridget, I really thought that was powerful because it's not just a story about racial discrimination here. It really commodifies all of us, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And I think you made such a great point earlier about the fact that this rink said that they were not using, you know, there was not a human who was checking to see if these two young women were actually the same person. They just went by this algorithm. And according to them, this software is 97% accurate. So why should they have a human actually see if this person is, you know, the person they say it is before they throw a child out into the street, right? I think it really comes down to who technology and who we allow for technology to be seen as human, as worthy of that kind of human connection, and who is just a commodity to be thrown out or thrown into jail because this algorithm or this software says they're the wrong person. And I also want to make another point, which is that this skating rink is not alone. Stores like Apple, Ace Hardware, Lowe's, Macy's, they are already using or have plans to use this kind of software. And so we are increasingly being more surveilled, and Black and brown communities, marginalized and already underrepresented communities, are the ones who are really bearing the brunt of this kind of thing. But I completely agree with her. I think it's not just a technology issue or a policing or a surveillance issue. It's an issue of who we see as human and who we see as worthy of being treated with basic human dignity. And it's certainly not black and brown folks.
Yeah, and she's so right. She listed a lot of the companies that are still using this facial recognition software. And then there's also Albertsons and HEB Grocery and Lowe's and all those different companies. And there's a coalition that's fighting this, and it's led by Fight for the Future. So make sure that you check that out and try to help them because it's unconscionable to do this, and these giant companies shouldn't agree to basically use discriminatory software like this, let alone any software in this situation like this. Jackson, last word.
This reminds me of the movie Minority Report with Tom Cruise. And it's, you know, I'm not even trying to be funny. You know, this is the type of direction and the type of vibe that this technology has. And just lastly, as someone who works in tech, I can tell you that technology is not yet to a point where computers can think and make human-like judgments. And if you don't have someone really monitoring things, then you don't really have anything that can be taken seriously or that's any type of responsible, you know. So let alone the technology being designed by people to where it more so recognizes and caters to the Caucasian group. But, you know, it's nice that they say it's 97% accurate, but you can lie. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you can just lie. So, yeah, you know, that really doesn't matter.
And by the way, they said that it was, that this case was a 97% match.
Yeah.
But it wasn't true. She wasn't that girl. So
how can they word things so that they can't get, you know, held too liable in court? You know, so
yeah,
that's really all it is.
Yep, that's exactly right. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.